60 set out from Cambridge, all good men and true, on a gunship bound for glory with a young and wild crew. We charge in, make our stand, and we'd see victory. But when we won our first battle, there were only 53. More died from infection, despite the surgeon's tricks, that brought our bold and fearless crew down to 46. We then sailed away, thinking we had seen the worst, but we steered her back around when we heard a cannon's burst. Second fight that day, and our luck was fading fast. Though we stayed afloat, we'd lost most of our main mast. We were now adrift and very glad to be alive, though I must admit our crew was now down to 35. Most of the food was ruined from the salt sea down below, but we didn't fear till the water started running low. With our bold and hardy crew just a fortnight out to sea, the cruel sea had taken 12 and we were 23. 4 more days had passed when we caught sight of a gale. We were sucking rain from the rags that used to be our sail. Another week adrift was the worst I'd ever seen. Our beleaguered crew was now down to just 17. The first mate started screaming and set the deck alight. We tried to restrain him, but he had a madman's fight. When we stopped him, he'd just hum, "It'll all be fine." But by then our battered crew was no more than 9. From 9 we went to 7, from 7 down to 3. The cabin boy, the carpenter, and the bosun, that was me. We all sat there on the deck, though none of us could speak. We should be keeping watch, but we were all too weak. The cabin boy was curled up in a corner all alone. The carpenter was muttering and gnawing on a bone. I just kept on laughing, 'cause I knew I'd lost my grip, as we were taken one by one to the rescue ship. Never go to sea, me boys, never leave the land. For once you're out to sea, it doesn't matter what you plan. Your life lies in the mercy of the sea, heartless and cruel. So you'll stay ashore unless you truly are a fool. Though 3 survived that awful trip, I'm the last one of my crew. The others locked in their own minds, their voyage never through. So listen to me, lads, before you take your hellish trip. Man belongs upon the ground, not on some goddamn ship.